be sold. The global trade in wildlife is now under new scrutiny as the possible origin of this pandemic. It is before the first human case, the coronavirus moved undetected across the species barrier. Genetic clues all point to a virus found in wild bats as the source, but working out exactly how the spillover from wildlife into humans happened isn't straightforward.
Part of the structure of every virus is essentially key that unlocks the specific cell that it needs to get inside. Now, if you imagine each of these padlocks is from a different species cell, they might require a different key. But some very different species actually share the same lock on their cells. And in the case of the coronavirus, the key from the bat virus fits and unlocks some human cells.
But how did it reach that first human cell that it unlocked? Its access was most likely not directly from bats, but via another intermediate host, an animal infected first that people came into close contact with. The scientists haven't yet worked out what species passed COVID-19 to a human, or whether that animal was for sale in the now infamous wildlife market in Wuhan.
At the moment, there is nothing that's terribly convincing about finding what the intermediate host was. And indeed, the intermediate host may never be found, but mixing large numbers of species under poor hygienic and welfare conditions and species that wouldn't normally come close together, that gives opportunities for pathogens to jump from species to species.
In previous outbreaks, that intermediate species has been found. Camels and palm civets have provided the likely route to humans for the closely related viruses MERS and SARS. And scientists have found clues about this chain of transmission in a list of animals, including rare and widely trafficked pangolins. But when wildlife is traded not only in China, but in almost every country, breaking those chains is a global challenge.
Victoria Gill reporting that.